Hi, good morning. Today is May 9th, 2019. Let's start with a quick question. I want you to post your answers in the comment section below. The question is, what is the meaning of Bangabandhu? Who gave the name, who gave this particular name or term called as Bangabandhu? Who is called as Bangabandhu and what is Bangabandhu 1? So these are the four questions that I have for you. And you have to answer these questions in the comment section below. Search for them on Google if you don't have the answers by yourself right now. But it does not matter. I want you to know a lot more about Bangabandhu. With that, let's start with the quiz for today. The first question is, who is the winner of Street Children's Cricket World Cup 2019? So I covered this about a week or two before. When we talked about the first Street Children's World Cup being held in the year 2019. So we talked about the ambassador for that. You have to provide me with the answer if you remember the ambassador of that in the comment section below. And the answer to this question is as usual and very proudly India. So India is the winner of Street Children's World Cup 2019. To be specific, South India. And this particular event has been organized by Street Child United in the United Kingdom. And it's the first of its kind Cricket World Cup being held for street children. So that's very important. High chances of it being asked at the examination. Let's come to second question. When is World Asthma Day? When is World Asthma Day observed? Please provide me with the answers in the comment section below. When is the World Asthma Day celebrated or observed? That is the right word. The answer to this question is A, May 7th. What is the theme of 2019 World Asthma Day? The answer is Stop for Asthma. That is very important. I think a question can also be asked based on the theme for 2019. And which organization observes World Asthma Day? The answer is Global Initiative for Asthma. Very easy to remember. No rocket science involved. Not difficult at all to remember this also. Okay. Let's come to the third question. RBI has raised the housing loans limit of regional rural banks and small finance banks to ₹1 lakh in metropolitans and ₹1 lakh in other centers for individuals to become eligible under priority sector lending. Please Google this particular news. It's very important. A question is certainly going to be asked from this when it comes to RBI examination, the upcoming RBI examination. So be very certain about all the limits, also the previous limits and the latest limits. The answer to this question is B, 35 and 25 lakh. Now in metropolitan centers, the limit is 35 lakh. And what is a metropolitan center? According to this or according to RBI, the metropolitan center definition is any center or any area with a population of 10 lakhs and above. The limit is 25 lakh in other centers, provided that the dwelling per unit cost cannot exceed 45 lakh in metropolitan centers and 30 lakh in the other centers or non-metropolitan centers. So these are two different limits. The first limit is the limit for loan and the second limit is the limit for cost of dwelling per unit. Okay, so these are important. I believe a question is certain from this particular area and going to be asked certainly in the examination. So go through the entire news item if you get time and if you're preparing for RBI examination. Next question, very important again. A detailed article was provided on this yesterday, in fact, in the Live Mint newspaper. So I'm discussing this today. The question is, what is the name of database where 36% of companies registered could not be traced or were wrongly classified according to NSSO study? NSSO has said that the government comes out with a data which says that, okay, these are the following companies and based on the performance of these following companies, we are saying that this is the GDP growth rate for this particular year. NSSO says that 36% of companies registered under the Ministry of Corporate Affairs 21A, that is MCA 21, database of companies actually do not exist. They are actually fake companies. Okay, so they don't exist. And they are being included in this database and they're also being used to calculate the annual GDP growth rate. So the entire annual GDP growth rate numbers that we have been looking for and that we've been believing are actually to a very large extent incorrect and overrated, just because all these companies which have been included in MCA 21 and their performance has been calculated and included in the GDP do not actually exist. Okay, so they've been wrongly classified. Next question, who has been appointed as the director of the feature film on the lives and works of Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman? So the third question that I asked gets answered here. Who is called as Bangabandhu? Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, who was the founder of Bangladesh. At the time of its creation, Sheikh Mujibur Rahman was one of the rebels or one of the founders of Bangladesh, just like Nehru and Mahatma Gandhi have been considered the founders of India. Okay, so the answer to this question is E, Shyam Benegal. Shyam Benegal has been appointed as the director because this particular movie has been officially produced by India and Bangladesh together. Three more questions that I had asked. What is the meaning of Bangabandhu? Who gave the term Bangabandhu? And what is Bangabandhu 1? You have to answer those questions. Let's come to the last question for today. The question is, who has been recently awarded with USA's highest honor, Presidential Medal of Freedom? The answer is very obvious. D. Tiger Woods, who recently won the Global Masters 2019 of golf. And based on his performance and based on his consistent performance for the last 2 to 3 decades, he has been awarded the USA's highest civilian honor, which is called as Presidential Medal of Freedom. So the answer is D, Tiger Woods. So that's all for today's current affairs. I hope you like the quiz that we have every day at 8 a.m. in the morning. If you want, you can also go through the current affairs on a daily basis by going to the website, and you can also take a detailed quiz which is also available on the website itself. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to get notifications about daily updates of these videos in the morning at 8 a.m. All the very best. Take care.